Well, I'm just leaving him around.
This guy thinks he's so fucking smooth. Little does he know. Now I'm just gonna pretend like I'm gonna run away and then force him to come towards me. Watch, you'll see what's gonna happen. Got you, bitch! I'm surprised I got lucky. But yeah guys, today's video, I want to discuss if Gears of War 3 Remastered is ever going to happen. And should it be made? And I'm going to say yes. And not only that, that is my favorite Gears of War of all of them. The original Gears of War 3, obviously. And I really miss that game a lot. I couldn't explain to you how much, like, all the greatness I had in that game. And man, I can't even explain, guys. I can't put words in this video how much I really, truly miss that game. I think it was the best Gears of War of all of them. And let's face it, guys. Gears of War 4 is not in a great state. There's so many issues in this game. And there's many YouTubers and people and forums online that explains what's going on with Gears of War 4. And I think it's very smart if they decide to make Gears of War 3 Remastered. Even Gears of War 2 Remastered would be good, too. But Gears 3 was like... there was something perfect about the game that just fits the multiplayer so much better than all the Gears of Wars. And right now, they should really do that because, let's face it, Xbox, you know, Xbox in general doesn't have a lot of exclusive games. And not only that, they're just... It's just things been dying very slowly, like even Halo. Like, Halo, like Halo's been dying because of, you know, Microsoft for 343 just adding some really dumb shit. And not only that, Coalition, I mean, let's face it, I do like Gears of War 4, but... there's a lot of things I can say about the game. For starters, let's talk about customization. It's pathetic. You need loot boxes to unlock stuff? Are you fucking kidding me? Like, who wants to spend real money to unlock things? Like, whatever happened to achieving things and you had to work and put a lot of hours in a game or objective to unlock something? I want that back in Gears of War 3 Remastered. And I can say all those things, but... And then in the end of the day, if microtransaction is ever added in Gears 3 Remastered, it's because of people. It's the people's fault, the fans' fault for continuing to purchase things and spend money on loot boxes. Like, really, guys? Like, do you have really that much money? And do you really want to support something that pathetic? That's really, like, I don't know, man. Like, that... It just pisses me off on so many levels. I just can't believe people will actually do that. If Coalition does end up making microtransactions, which I'm pretty sure they will, and oh man, just by thinking about it is really pissing me off. But anyway, if they end up doing it, at least bring back the original way of achieving things in Gears of War 3. Like, you know, unlocking the Honest Guard or the Golden Hunter or the Golden Miner. Who remembers that? Like, if you guys remember that, please comment below on my channel. And it took a lot of effort to get those guys. It was not easy whatsoever. But if they do end up putting microtransactions, I mean, please don't put it like on every single thing you had to do to unlock things. I don't want to see that in Gears of War 3 Remastered. Another thing I don't want to see in Gears of War 3 Remastered is just like new maps. Like, I doubt they're ever going to add new maps, but bring back all the original maps. Just make it look amazing. And don't, like, remaster the maps that make sense. Make it look like what it looked like in Gears of War 3, but with better graphics, obviously, and better textures. But don't change the environment and or the whole look of the map. Just change, like, the actual graphics. Like, I definitely do not want to see that Gears of War 3 remastered. And not only that, let's face it, in Gears of War 4, Coalition is so lazy. Their business strategy was to remaster maps because, you know, why not? If something's not broken, then don't break it. But they were so lazy on making... just original maps in their own way. I can't think of a map that I really like in Gears of War 4. And only that, all you see is remastered maps. It just saves them money to do those things too. So that's why. That's their business strategy. Another thing I really want to see in Gears of War 3 Remastered is just like 60 frames per second. I want an Xbox gamers able to experience 60 frames per second. Yeah, I know the Xbox X just came out, but it's not fair for players that don't have a 4K TV or have the money to spend, you know, for an Xbox X just to be able to run 60 frames per second. I heard a lot of great things about Gears of War 4 on the Xbox X. I heard it's amazing looking, but I don't care about 4K just yet. I have an Xbox X myself. I'm ready to play Battlegrounds, and I'm very excited to play that, but I'll save it for another time. But other than that, like, I have a pretty beastly PC, and I want to talk about my huge advantages playing a PC. Now, I don't necessarily play on huge graphical settings because, to me, it's a very big disadvantage, and it's much easier to lower the graphic settings, and it's much easier for me to play Gears of War. It makes it more easier for me to take opponents out with my mouse and keyboard, especially when my frames per second is much higher. So what I'm trying to say is if the original Xbox One could just run 60 frames per second for Gears of War 3, that would be phenomenal. If they have to sacrifice graphics performance, so what? Do it, you know? But obviously, if you have the Xbox X, it's going to be able to run 60 frames per second in 4K or even 1080p, I think. But that would be phenomenal if Xbox gamers could have a dedicated 60 frames per second constantly in Gears of War 3 Remastered. Because I can't explain to you guys how important it is to run 60 frames per second. It's a huge advantage, and if you guys know nothing about it, you guys should really research it. It's very important. And I'm letting you guys know that my game is able to run more than 60 frames per second, so I can't explain to you how smooth Gears of War 4 is on my PC. So I just want Xbox gamers to experience high frame rates for Gears of War 3 Remastered, and I think it's going to be wonderful. One thing I definitely want to see in Gears of War 3 Remastered is the ranking system again, like the original way. Like, oh my god, guys, like Gears of War 4 ranking system is so fucking stupid. Like, anybody watching this video right now, hands down, can accept what I'm saying. Maybe not 100%, but look at this. I can't even explain how many matches I have joined, and I'm a diamond, the highest rank. And not only that, I can't even find matches in Execution or Warzone or barely any other matches, just Team Deathmatch. But anyway, like, long story short, when I'm playing Team Deathmatch, I swear to you guys, I sometimes queue up with people low ranks. I'm just like, really? Like, why? Like, oh my god, like, that drives me insane. But like I said, back in the day, back in Gears of War 1 days, you join any match, you don't know how good they were. There wasn't no real ranking system. There was just leaderboards to determine how much, you know, hours players put in and what rank they are in the world. But now things change, guys. Like, this is Gears of War 4. There's so many other Gears of War titles. They should have now a dedicated ranking system. And oh my god, like, it's just so bad. I can't explain to you. Not only that, ranked match is kind of dead. I don't think a lot of people play it. A lot of people just play social matches now. I hope you guys get my point. I just want a real dedicated ranking system where everything takes skill. Not only that, like, it takes skill to win matches, and it takes skill to keep the rank that you have, or you earn, I'm sorry. But I think it should happen, and I think Coalition should just, you know, like, wake the fuck up and do something about it, because we want to have an amazing, fun experience. But I think Gears of War 3 Remastered is going to happen one day, because let's face it, I'm not too excited for Gears of War 5 because of Gears of War 4. And they're going to have to remaster the older Gears of War games, and let's face it, guys, everybody's going to jump back into Gears 2 and Gears 3 if they do it. So, not only that, oh my god, if you guys played the original Gears of War 3 and Xbox One, it is so fucking trash. The frame rate is unbelievably bad. I tried playing it, and oh my god, I was so beyond pissed off and disappointed. I'm just like, you guys couldn't, like, make the game work on a console that runs faster than the older console back in the day? Like, really? Like, what does it take for it to work properly? But, well, it's a huge disappointment. And not only that, to this day, I don't think it's ever fixed, because there is not enough people that wants to play Gears 3 on the Xbox One, and nobody has made feedback about it. If Coalition could make a dedicated ranking system, and then if they stop being money hungry and take out microtransactions, and add a Gears of War 3 Remastered, and, you know, like the original way, oh my god, guys, there's gonna be so many people, because, you know, gonna be playing Gears of War 3 Remastered, and a lot of people are gonna be so excited to jump back into it. But another thing that should really happen is they should add maps, original old maps that never came in Gears 3. I don't know if people will agree what I'm saying, but I kind of think they should. I think it would be great if they could add, like, Field Depot back in Gears 3 or any certain other maps like Mansion back to Gears 3. I think it'll be really, really cool. But I'll let you guys tell me below my video and let me know if that's a good thing or a really bad idea, because that could cause some issues. It could cause like weapon balancing issues. Like there's some weapons that are in Gears 3, obviously, that might not suit the playstyle of Gears of War 1 maps. Here's an example, the Retro Lancer and the Hammer Burst. Guys, you remember in Gears 3, you could choose one of the three weapons, and it was really, really unique and cool, and it makes you play the different playstyle using those weapons. Even though the Lancer is the most superior rifle in the game, but using the Retro and the Hammer Burst does benefit your certain playstyle. But like, let's talk about the map, Mansion, for example. If you use a Retro Lancer in Mansion, the map is so close quarters, that weapon will probably own any weapon. Like, it will be way more effective than the Lancer and the Hammer Bird. So, do you guys get my point? Like, what will happen if they do add maps like that? But, I don't know. That's just my opinion. But comment below, let me know if you think that's a bad idea. But the point of this video, guys, is you guys gotta remember, I'm just trying to, like make videos on my opinions. What's gonna make the game even much better and much more fun and much joyful. Not only that, like, I hope this video gets big one day and Call of Legend looks in his video and looks with the fans' feedback, what they had to say. But even though they're not going to care too much, because at the end of the day, they're still going to add microtransactions and make money off us. And the only way it's going to end is if we, you know, as fans come together and just let them know what's, like, wrong with the game and what they're sick of. And, you know, that's the way it's going to end. I don't know if you guys play Star Wars Battlefront, but I didn't like Star Wars Battlefront 1. I thought it was a really shit game, but if you guys hear in the news, Star Wars Battlefront 2, they took on microtransactions because the fans got really sick and tired, and not only that, it was a pay-to-win game. Even though they said they're gonna add microtransactions later on, but you guys get my point, like, people's voices really matter, and it can really change the game. The next thing they should add in Gears 3 Ultimate Edition is they should add a cross-platform, even though I think it's gonna happen anyway. I think it was such a great experience in Gears of War 4. They're able to play with console players on the PC. And I thought it was really unique. And only that, like, let's face it, even though the huge advantages on the PC over a console, there are so many good console players out there playing Gears of War 4. I've seen a lot of talented console players. And I'm not gonna lie, they gave me one hell of a challenge. I lost a couple games from them. And I think that cross-platform is a very unique thing they added, and I think it's going to make Gears of War 3 Ultimate Edition such a fun experience. I also think they should add mouse and keyboard for Gears of War 3 Ultimate Edition for console players. Now, I think that if they add it, it'll make the game even way more interesting for console players to be able to use mouse and keyboard. If you're using a comfortable setup, of course, but if you're in a, you know, if you're in a couch, laying on the couch on TV, yeah, mouse and keyboard's not gonna work for you. But if you're on the desk and you're playing on a monitor or a pretty big TV, then mouse and keyboard would be such a cool thing to be added. But like I said, mouse and keyboard is a really unique thing. Yeah, a lot of people are not gonna fully understand how to use one right off the bat. But with some practice, you guys should be able to get used to it. But I think mouse and keyboard would be very unique, because I'm telling you guys right now, mouse and keyboard is such a huge advantage. Especially when using a sniper rifle, and aiming is so much easier. I can't really explain to you guys, but what I'm trying to say is I just want console players to be able to experience, you know, those things. They're able to benefit your gameplay, and I think it's very fair for them to happen. But that's also Microsoft's, like, decision whether it should be added or not. I always think it should be added in a way. And the only way for you to be able to use mouse and keyboard on a console is you buy this adapter called the Sim 4. Very pricey. I used it before and it's very cool. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. But I really, really hope Gears Ultimate Edition is gonna be made one day. And like I said earlier, it's gonna happen for sure. Call of Legends gonna run out of ideas to make newer Gears of War titles, and they have to go back to the old roots eventually. I really think it's gonna do that. And I think it's really gonna happen, and I'm pretty sure anybody's watching this video agrees with me. But I really hope Gears 3 Ultimate Edition mind blows me, because that was my favorite Gears of War, like I said. I had so much great memories on the multiplayer, and not even just the multiplayer, the campaign was so great too. It was so much fun, I can't explain to you guys, like, man, I just really miss it. I wish it releases one day very soon. I just want to be able to play that great game. Like, I'd rather be playing that game than Gears 4 any single day. But anyway, guys, I'm very sorry making this video very long. I just want to, like, be able to display my opinions. And everybody's opinions right now, as we speak, really matters. I want you guys to really comment below my video and let me know what you guys want to see happen in Gears of War 3 Ultimate Edition. because everybody's opinion, like I said, really matters at this moment. But feel free to, you know, spread this video as much as you can and just let people know, like, this should happen. Like, everybody's voice really matters. But if they end up making a Gears 3 Ultimate Edition, I swear to you guys, I will flip, and I will be so happy if they do. I just hope they don't add microtransactions, and I hope they add dedicated servers, and I hope they also give a great, like, graphical frame rate experience for the console gamers. And I really hope they add, like, achievements and things for you to unlock and work to get skins or characters. Because, man, I really miss that playstyle in Gears of War. I'm very sick and tired of microtransactions and all that fucking garbage. I am very confident that if this ever happens, I think that many fans will be jumping back to the Xbox. And Xbox sales and a whole bunch of other sales will go up. I'm guaranteeing that will happen. But who knows what's going to be out there for the future for Gears of War. But Gears of War needs to go back to its main roots. But anyway, guys, that's all I had to say. I hope you guys relate to all the things I say. I hope most of you guys agree with my opinion, what I had to say. But comment below my channel. Let me know, like, what should happen for Gears 3 Ultimate Edition. And not only that, like my video. And subscribe to my channel if you guys would like to see more content. But bye-bye.